activity of the student council of Adamalai Homeopathic Medical College. We have been conducting this since 11 years and it was earlier related to the participation of the students from various pre-university colleges in the literary as well as in the cultural activities. This time we thought of giving a new dimension, that is involving the students to get involved in the medical as well as the health sector, try to give them some creativity and try to work on their ideas so that they can be better understood about the health as well as the awareness of diseases. On this day we have got amidst us our director, Reverend Father Richard Aloysius Coelho, the president of this today's program, and also the director of charitable institutions who is going to preside over this program and carry on this program. Director has been a great support for all our programs and he has given his consent and he has given all the facilities required for this. Father, on behalf of all the people gathered here, welcome to this program. May I request our administrator to offer him a ticket and welcome him to the group. Thank you, Father. We have a very popular, well-known social worker, I can say, more than a politician, person who has excelled in this constituency, the earlier Ullar constituency, now it is called as the Mangalore constituency, Sri U.T. Khadar, who is born and brought up in Mangalore. Imbibed recipient from his committed parents, late Haji Farid and Nasima, who are well known for their generosity. He has developed his identity as a committed social entrepreneur, a law graduate. He has represented the Mangalore constituency since 2007, undefeated leader of this constituency, Mr. Khadar. He was the Minister of Health and Family Welfare of Karnataka from 20th May 2013 to 20th June 2016. In his journey to our institution, his support and his giving us the encouragement was quite immense. You say anything related to Ayush with homeopathy at Vadamula Homeopathy College level or at the district level, sir has contributed a lot, and the Ayush hospital, which is finding its place, within few months it is going to be inaugurated, it is his brainchild and his contribution. Also was the Minister of Food and Citizen Suppliers and Consumer Affairs, during which a lot of innovative ideas like Patikara Bhagya, Ration Card Simplification, Anna Bhagya, Kshira Bhagya, all these, and he was also the Urban Minister, Urban Development and Housing Minister of Karnataka State, and the city, 1985, you see, developed today, in 2019, a transformation, his contribution. Welcome, Sri U.T. Khadar, to this program. I request our director to offer you. Totally committed, very simple, very humble, but he is to the masses. That is none other than Sri Srina Shetty. He is education, he is a social worker, but if you see him, he is a person who is with the masses at various villages of this district. He is a district sanitation ambassador and he is also the director of Jana Shikshana Trust. And in his tenure, he has given us also the Valepuri village where we are having a Mane the Ayush program as well as the reaching the children who are having malnutrition. He is giving us all the opportunities, serving the community. He is with us as a guest of honor. I welcome you, sir. I request Dr. Rajachandra, the co-convener, to offer him a bouquet. Academician and administrator. It is a tradition in Adamalai Homeopathic Medical College, whenever we conduct Prerana, we invite the principals of colleges to be a chief guest or the guest of honor, and we are blessed to have one such administrator, the principal, Sister Dr. M. Jasvina, the principal of St. Agnes College, Mangalore. She is a MA from Mysore University, MPhil and PhD from Calicut University, Kerala. She has 28 years of teaching experience and she has written lots of books on value education, syllabus of UC degree classes, Life of St. Agnes and Covenant of Law Catechism books. She is an expert member of the Advisory Committee to Audit Colleges under the CPEC scheme under UGC. She is also chairperson of the Committee for Physical Verification of RUSA Colleges approved by the Government of Karnataka and excellent committee member for the UGC Colleges. On behalf of all the people of Canada, I welcome you, sister, to this program. My request, Dr. Deepa Pais, to offer a welcome. The principals of various colleges and our students who have given a great support to this program. I just want to end with one. This is the students program. I want to announce here, yesterday we got a notification from the Rajiv Gandhi University, Father Mullah's Homeopathic Medical College, overall 4 years rank list has been established. Father Mullah's College got 6 out of 10 undergraduate ranks. 6 out of 10 undergraduate and 8 of 14 postgraduate ranks which is declared by Rajiv Gandhi University. Congratulations students, I wish this program to be all the best.
Thank you, Father. The second release there will not notes on everyone. I request ma'am come on the dais. Principal St. Agnes College Mangalore to do the honors.
First is, I want to congratulate Father Roshan and entire faculty for putting up this program. Very excellent one. Secondly, I would like to congratulate entire team, Father Roshan, principal, faculty, for bringing 6 ranks to our college in the UG program. 1 to 5, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, then one more rank, last I think, 10. So many ranks have come. Congratulations to everybody, students. Third, Dr. Vilma and Dr. Rita Chakravarti. You witnessed the program just now. It is not an easy task, but they have done it. Therefore, congratulations to them also. One word about our chief guest. He told me, Father, you can proceed, I will continue. Sir is always very close to our institution, Father Mullah Charitable Institution, and he has done a lot. So on this occasion, I just want to thank him on behalf of every one of you. Sister Josephina, principal of St. Agnes College. You must remember, the first college in India for women is St. Agnes College, Bangalore. Not only here, first college in India only for women, I think it is Bangalore, St. Agnes. And when introduction was given, you students clapped a lot. I know why. Why? Because sister has had a PhD in Calicut University. I know that. But remember, it is not in Malayalam, in English. Okay? I do appreciate your love and culture for your state. Fine. Lastly, please allow me to go. All the best. May God bless you.
At the outset, let me congratulate the organizers, Father Mullah Homeopathic Hospital, for providing an opportunity to the high school and PU students to showcase your talents. Prerna 2020 has brought all of you together from 2 districts, Dakshina Kannada and Udupi, to take part in the various competitions. All of you have come here well prepared with great zeal and enthusiasm, with one desire and goal in life, and that is to win the trophy, to win in all the competitions and to take the trophy home. We all know that among so many participants, just a few will win. What is important in a competition is participation. Winning and losing is part and parcel of our life. The values and principles that you imbibe during the competitions are greater than just winning a prize. What do you learn in a competition? Well, You learn to take responsibilities, which is very essential. You are trained to work as a team, and that is very important, because today if you don't learn to work as a team, life becomes very difficult. And then you begin to understand one another. When you work as a team, you know one another's strengths and weaknesses, and if something goes wrong in the group, you also learn to forgive one another. And also the spirit of giving and taking, to adjust with one another, and many things. That is why a competition is a healthy competition, and therefore we must all prepared to accept both success and failures. It is during such competitions you are groomed, your character is formed, and as a result you are able to accept both success and failures with resignation or equanimity. You do not lose hope. No, just because you win, you don't become very great, and just because you lose, you don't get depressed or despondent. Life itself is a competition, and in our life's journey, we come across a number of challenges. And if the foundation of our life at a very early age, like yours, built on values and principles, be sure you will be able to face any obstacles, challenges, problems and difficulties. Father, besides the competition, today Father Mullah Hospital, Homeopathic Hospital, has created one more opportunity for you, and that is the health exhibition. You must be all eager to get a glimpse of this medical science. It will be a great help for you to know more about medicine and its impact. You will get educated when you go through this exhibition and learn a number of facts of life, and especially the importance of health, the advancement in the field of medicine, nutrition, diet, and how to maintain good health, and many other things. I wish good luck to all the participants present here, and I wish that you learn more on medicine. Thank you, and God bless you all.
ಉತ್ತಮ ಗುಣಮಟ್ಟದ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ಮತ್ತು ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಸೇವೆಯನ್ನು ನಿರಂತರವಾಗಿ ನೀಡುತ್ತಾ ಕರಾವಳಿ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಸುಸ್ಥಿರ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ, ಸುಸ್ಥಿರ ಅಭಿವೃದ್ಧಿಗೆ ಮಹತ್ತರ ಕೊಡುಗೆಯನ್ನು ನೀಡುತ್ತಾ ಬಂದಿರುವ ಫಾದರ್ ಮುಲ್ಲರ್ ಆಸ್ಪತ್ರೆ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆ ಮತ್ತು ಅದರ ಅಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತಿರುವಂತಹ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ಆಸ್ಪತ್ರೆಯ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ನಾನು ಅಭಿನಂದಿಸುವಂತಹದ್ದು. 1986 ಈ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಸಂಪರ್ಕ. ನಾವು ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಸೇವೆ ಪಡೆದಿದ್ದು ಮತ್ತು ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಸೇವೆ ನೀಡುವಲ್ಲಿ ಸಹಕರಿಸಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಕಳೆದ ವರ್ಷ ಬಂಟ್ವಾಳ ತಾಲೂಕು ಬಾಳೆಪುಣ್ಯವನ್ನು ಆಯುಷ್ ಗ್ರಾಮ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಅಭಿಯಾನದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಆಡಳಿತಾಧಿಕಾರಿಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಪ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಪಾಲ್ ಅವರ ಸಹಯೋಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಆಯುಷ್ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಅಭಿಯಾನ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಕಳೆದ ವರ್ಷ ಬಾಳೆಪುಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ 4 ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಶಿಬಿರಗಳನ್ನು ನಡೆಸಿರುವುದು. ಬಾಳೆಪುಣೆ ಪಂಚಾಯತ್ ವ್ಯಾಪ್ತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ 3,000 ಮನೆಗಳಿದ್ದು 3,000 ಮನೆಗಳಿಗೂ ಆಯುಷ್ ಅಥವಾ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ಅರಿವು ಮತ್ತು ಔಷಧಿಯನ್ನು ನೀಡಿ ರೋಗಮುಕ್ತ ಆರೋಗ್ಯವಂತರ ಗ್ರಾಮವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಫಾದರ್ ಮುಲ್ಲರ್ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ವೈದ್ಯಕೀಯ ಕಾಲೇಜು ಮತ್ತು ಆಸ್ಪತ್ರೆ, ಆಯುಷ್ ಇಲಾಖೆ, ಜನ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ಟ್ರಸ್ಟ್, ಬಾಳೆಪುಣೆ ಗ್ರಾಮ ಪಂಚಾಯತ್ ಜಂಟಿಯಾಗಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಪ್ರೇರಣಾ 2020 ಸಾಹಿತ್ಯ ಸೃಜನಶೀಲತೆ ಮತ್ತು ವೈದ್ಯಕೀಯ ಪ್ರದರ್ಶನ ಒಂದು ಉತ್ತಮವಾದ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ. ಸದ್ಯದ ಕಾಲಘಟ್ಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಮನಸ್ಸು ಬಿಚ್ಚುವಂಥ ಕೆಲಸ ಆದರೆ ಈ ಪ್ರೇರಣಾ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಮನಸ್ಸನ್ನು ಕಟ್ಟುವಂಥದ್ದು, ಮನಃಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ವೃದ್ಧಿಸುವಂಥದ್ದು, ಬುದ್ಧಿ ವಿಕಾಸಗೊಳಿಸುವಂತಹದ್ದು, ಆಸಕ್ತಿ ಕೆರಳಿಸುವಂತಹ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ತಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರುವುದು. ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿತ್ವ, ಮತ್ತು ದೇಶವನ್ನು ಉನ್ನತ ಮಟ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಈ ಪ್ರೇರಣಾ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಇಪ್ಪತ್ತಿಪ್ಪತ್ತು ಪ್ರೇರಣೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. 11ನೇ ವರ್ಷದ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ತಾವು ನಡೆಸ್ತಾ ಇರುವುದು. ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ 100 ವರ್ಷ ನಡೆಯಬೇಕು, ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಇದು ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಶವನ್ನು ವಿಶ್ವ ಮಟ್ಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಜೆದ್ದು ಕಾಣಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಹಾಯ ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ವಿಶೇಷವಾದ ವಿನೂತನವಾದ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ. ಈಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಜಿಲ್ಲೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಿಟ್ಟಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಮುಂದೆ ಇದೆ, ಆದರೆ ಕಸದ ವಿಷಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹಿಂದೆ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆಯೇ ಸಮೃದ್ಧಿ, ಸ್ವಾಭಿಮಾನಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆ, ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆಯೇ ಸಮೃದ್ಧಿ, ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆಯೇ ಸಂಸ್ಕೃತಿ. ಅಶಕ್ತರ ಅನುಕೂಲಕ್ಕೆ, ಎಲ್ಲರ ಆರೋಗ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ, ಕುಟುಂಬ ಹಾಗೂ ಗ್ರಾಮದ ಗೌರವಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರತಿ ಮನೆ, ಶಾಲೆ, ಅಂಗನವಾಡಿ, ಹೋಟೆಲ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಬಳಕೆಗೆ ಯೋಗ್ಯವಾದ ಶೌಚಾಲಯ, ಕಂಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಗುಂಡಿ, ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ತ್ಯಾಜ್ಯ ನಿರ್ವಹಣೆ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆಯನ್ನು ಕಡ್ಡಾಯವಾಗಿ ನಿರ್ಮಿಸಿ ನಿರಂತರವಾಗಿ ನಿರ್ವಹಿಸಬೇಕು. ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆಯೋ ಅಲ್ಲಿದ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ, ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣ ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆ ಇರುವಲ್ಲಿ ದೇವರು ನೆಲೆಸುತ್ತಾರೆ. ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆಯೋ ಅಲ್ಲಿದ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ, ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣ ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆ ಇರುವಲ್ಲಿ ದೇವರು ನೆಲೆಸುತ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂತರಂಗ ಬಹಿರಂಗ ಶುದ್ಧತೆ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ದೈವತಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗುತ್ತದೆ. ಅಂತರಂಗ ಬಹಿರಂಗ ಶುದ್ಧತೆ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ದೈವತಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗುತ್ತದೆ. ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಕಸವನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲೆಂದರಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿಸಾಡುವುದು ಮತ್ತು ಸುಡುವುದು ತಪ್ಪು, ಪಾಪ, ದೋಷ, ಶಾಪ. ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಹೊಗೆ, ಅದು ವಿಷದ ಹೊಗೆ, ಗರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಶಿಶುವನ್ನು ಅಂಗವಿಕಲ ಮಾಡುವ ಹೊಗೆ, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸರ್ ತರುವ ಹೊಗೆ. ಈ ಪ್ರೇರಣಾ ಇಪ್ಪತ್ತು ಇಪ್ಪತ್ತು ದಕ್ಷಿಣ ಕನ್ನಡ ಮತ್ತು ಉಡುಪಿ ಜಿಲ್ಲೆಯ ಸುಮಾರು 2000 ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಮನಸ್ಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆ ಜಾಗೃತಿ ಮೂಡಿಸಬೇಕು. ಪ್ರತಿ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಸಿ ಮತ್ತು ಒಣ ಕಸವನ್ನು ವಿಂಗಡಿಸಿ ಸಮರ್ಪಕವಾಗಿ ನಿರ್ವಹಿಸಿ ಸ್ವಚ್ಛ ಮನೆ, ಸೋಲಾರ್ ಮನೆ, ಹಸಿರು ಮನೆ, ಸೌಹಾರ್ದ ಮನೆ, ಸ್ವಚ್ಛ ಗ್ರಾಮ, ಸೋಲಾರ್ ಗ್ರಾಮ, ಹಸಿರು ಗ್ರಾಮ, ಸೌಹಾರ್ದ ಗ್ರಾಮ ಕಟ್ಟುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಪ್ರೇರಣೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಬಳಿಕ ಬದಲಾಗುವವರು ಬಚವಾಗುತ್ತಾರೆ, ಬದಲಾವಣೆಗೆ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಬದಲಾಗುವವರು ಯಶಸ್ವಿಯಾಗುತ್ತಾರೆ, ಬದಲಾವಣೆಗೆ ಕಾರಣರಾಗುವವರು ನಾಯಕರಾಗುತ್ತಾರೆ. ವೇದಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲಿದ್ದವರು ತಾವು ಈ ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಕಾರಣಕರ್ತ ತಾವಿದ್ದೀರಿ. ಬದಲಾವಣೆಗೆ ಪ್ರೇರಕ ಪೂರಕವಾಗಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರುವುದು. ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆಗೆ ಸಮೃದ್ಧಿ, ಸ್ವಾಭಿಮಾನಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆ, ಮನೆಗೊಂದು ಶೌಚಾಲಯ, ಕಾಯಿಲೆಗಳಿಗೆ ವಿದಾಯ, ಕಕ್ಕೂಸು ಕಟ್ಟಿಸಿ ಕಾಯಿಲೆಗಳ ಅಟ್ಟಿಸಿ. ಸ್ವಚ್ಛ ಧಾಮ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಧಾಮ, ವಿಷಕಾರಿ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಅಪಾಯಕಾರಿ, ಅಪಾಯಕಾರಿ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ವಿಷಕಾರಿ. ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಚೀಲ ಬಿಡೋಣ, ಬಟ್ಟೆ ಚೀಲ ಹಿಡಿಯೋಣ, ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ರೀತಿ, ಪ್ರಾಣಕ್ಕೆ ಭೀತಿ, ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ತೋರಣ ತಂದೀತು ಮರಣ. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ.
But before leaving the campus, learn Kannada. Because we won't know after your education where you'll go and serve as homeopathic doctor. You may join any hospital or any place. But when you go there, if you don't know the local language, then it will be a problem for the patient, not for you. Because she'll tell her sickness, he won't understand. He'll give some other medicine to her. So it is an opportunity for the students to learn how many languages it is possible. So much language should be learned by all the students who have got an opportunity. And we should understand that any language to be good, to develop, if we hate one language, another language doesn't develop. When we learn one language, automatically another language will develop. So always I say, Marathi border, Marathi people border Karnataka, they should learn Marathi. Maharashtra people should learn Kannada. The border area of this area, Mangalore people should learn Malayalam, Malayalam people should learn Kannada. This should be easy, because even when I was going to school in St. Aloysius, I thought why should learn Hindi? If I learn it is enough, only pass marks is enough to pass. So we don't interact with it too much. But now I'm handicapped. When I go to Delhi or some other UP, they can understand my language, I can understand their language. And now I'm suffering, I'm thinking, actually, when my teachers and father to tell me to learn Hindi thoroughly, if I learned that in Aloysius, I could have been a national level, I could have taken participate in all the programs. So tomorrow you should get an opportunity, wherever you go, to that capacity to communicate with the people of that area. So I'm wishing each and everyone a bright future. I congratulate all the students who are standing, who are learning, who are taking the education on homeopathic in this institution. You are always lucky, and I think you have to always thank your parents and whoever responsible to come and to get an admission in this institution. Because Father Mala's homeopathic institution, one of the best homeopathic institution throughout India and well known throughout the world also. Tomorrow, wherever you go, after your graduation, taking a certificate, you go to any country, when you have got a certificate of Father Mullah's homeopathic institution, automatically you will get a first preference to have your service over there. And I thank all the
Reverend Fathers, the directors, the principals and all the intuition faculty members to keeping up this mark of this saint Father Mother Homeopathic Intuition. Year by year it goes higher and higher by various programs whatever done. It is not only a good name for your intuition, it's entire South Canada district and for the Karnataka also. Ultimately, all this program will benefit the society, I like to say. ಎಲ್ಲವೂ ಕೂಡ ಇದು ಸಮಾಜಕ್ಕೆ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಪೂರಕವಾಗುವಂಥ ಪ್ರಯೋಜನ ಇವತ್ತು ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಸೇ ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿಸ್ಮಕ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಎಲೋಪತಿ, ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ, ಆಯುರ್ವೇದ, ಸಿದ್ಧ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್. ಅವರ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪೇಷಂಟ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್. ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಪೇಷಂಟ್ ನೀಡ್ಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಗಿವನ್. And I have to tell all the doctors, allopathy doctors also, you don't see a patient as only allopathy patient. See him as a patient. Wherever he needs your allopathy, you give allopathy. Wherever he needs your Ayurveda or yoga or homeopathy, that's your duty. A doctor should look at a patient as a patient, not as an allopathy patient only. And every medicine has got its own importance, and every medicine, the modern medicines, ultimately principles are copied from each other. All allopathy, any medicine, let it be there. Ultimately when you go to the down level in different medicines area, a lot of homeopathy principles are used in allopathy, but they don't tell. Same way in Ayurvedic also are used in, it's a refined model of allopathy is nothing but I said in a national conference, allopathy is nothing but a refined model of Ayurveda and homeopathy and other medicine, traditional medicine what is there, it refined a new model of allopathy. So now it is your duty, take into confidence, you have Atma Vishwasa nimgellari kuda barbeku, ee allopathy bala chennagi kalibeku, matte hogi allopathy, sorry, homeopathy nimge chennagi kalibeku, matte homeopathy nimge practice madbeku. Illi homeopathy kaltu neevu alli allopathy madde hodre homeopathy improve madlikke ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ಕಲಿತು ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ಬಿಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪ್ಯಾಥ್ ಗೋಟ್ ಎನಿ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿ ಏರಿಯಾ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಎ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಟ್ ಎಮ್ ಆಟೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ಲಿ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಆಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಬ್ರೈಟ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಡೇಸ್ ಟು ಕಮ್. ನಾವು ಅವರ್ ಡಿಸಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಯುರ್ವೇದ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಜಗತ್ ಕ್ಲಿನಿಕ್ ದನ್ ದೆ ಗಿವ್ ಆಲೋಪತಿ ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್ ದೆನ್ ವೇರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಫೆಮಿಲಿಯರ್ ವಿತ್ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ. ದೇ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಟು ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಯರ್ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ದಿ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಐ ಕಾಂಗ್ರ್ಯಾಚುಲೇಟ್ ಟು ಫ್ಯಾಕಲ್ಟಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಬುಕ್ಸ್. ಸಿ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಸಂಶೋಧನೆಯಿಲ್ಲದೆ ಏನು ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಆದಷ್ಟು ನೀವು ಕಲಿಬೇಕು, ಸಂಶೋಧನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಮತ್ತು ಬುಕ್ಸ್ ಬರೀಬೇಕು. ಅದರ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿಗೆ ವಿಶೇಷವಾದ ಅದು ಶಕ್ತಿ ಕೊಡದ ಕೆಲಸ ಇವತ್ತು ಆಗಬೇಕಂದು ನಾನು ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಇವತ್ತು ಬಯಸ್ಕೊಂಡು. ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ವಲಯದ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಐ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಗೆಟ್. ಇನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಓಪನಿಂಗ್ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ಲಿ. ವೆನ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ವಿದ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ವೆನ್ಲಾಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ 50-bedded ಆಯುಷ್ ವೇರ್ ಯು ಗಾಟ್ ಆಯುರ್ವೇದ ಯೋಗ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯುನಾನಿ ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಫುಲ್ ಫ್ಲೆಜ್ಲಿ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಅವರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಕಮ್, ಐ ಮೇ ನೀಡ್ ಎಲಮತಿ, ಮೈ ಫಾದರ್ ಮೇ ನೀಡ್ ಆಯುರ್ವೇದ, ಮೈ ಮದರ್ ಮೇ ನೀಡ್ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ. ದೇ ಕಾನ್ ರನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಟು ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ಯು ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಒನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದ ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಒಂದೇ ಜಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಕ್ಕುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ. ಆದ ಕಾರಣ ಇದು ವೆನ್ ಇನ್ನೊಗಸ್ಟ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟೆಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಸೂನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇನಾಗ್ರೇಟ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ವೇ ದಿಸ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಪಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟುಮಾರೋ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್. ಟುಮಾರೋ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ತಾಲೂಕ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್, ದೆನ್ ಮೇ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ವಿಲೇಜ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್, ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಗಿವ್. ಸೊ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಯು ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ಫೆಮಿಲಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಶುಡ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೌ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ವೆರಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ದಿ ಫಾದರ್ ಮುಲ್ಲರ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ ಅಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿಲ್ಟ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲ್ ಇನ್ ಉಲ್ಲಾಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. and it's one of the model hospital which is there in the village areas. And if you all agree, I think we can tie up with the Father Mullah's homeopathic institution. You can start a clinic there also in our institution, where the people will get an opportunity to get this homeopathic treatment, and you're opposite to your students also can be with the more access to the people in the days to come, that we'll discuss in days to come. I think today we all have to remember Father Mullah, because 140-132 ವರ್ಷಗಳ ಹಿಂದೆ ಕಂಕನಾಡಿನ ಪ್ರದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದು ಗೋಲಿದ ಮರಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಆ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಅನ್ನು ತಂದಾಗ ಆ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಬಾಂಬ್ ಅವರು ತಂದದಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಆ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಅವ್ರು ತಂದದ್ದು ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿಕ್ ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್. ಆ ಮರದಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ದೇ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರೀಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ದುಡ್ಡಿಗಲ್ಲ, ಫ್ರೀ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್. ಆವಾಗ ಬಹುಶಃ ಶೋಸೈ ಅವರ ಆ ಒಂದು ಸಾಮಾಜಿಕ ಸೇವೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬಂದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಸಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಟ್ರೀ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಪೋರ್ ಪೇಷಂಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಹೋಮಿಯೋಪತಿಕ್ ಮೆಡಿಸನ್ಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟುಡೇ ಇಟ್ ಹಸ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅ ಬಿಗ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಡೇಸ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ದೇ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಗುಡ್ ಇನ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಮುಲ್ಲಾಸ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಒನ್ ವಿಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದೋಸ್ ಡೇಸ್ ಹಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಸಚ್ ಅ ರಿವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. So we also remember their initiative, their service, and I think it should be an inspiration for all the students of this institution also. So nimgellaranna vishesha subhashana niyottu salisikondu ee ondu prerana karyakrama bosha namgellari kuda ivattu dodda mattada prerana aglikke ivattu avakasha kodtare ella vidyarthi vidyarthi vastupanda delegate and inspiration in the days to come. So even they will be attracted to the, they will come to know about this homeopathic medicines. And you are given a wonderful opportunity also. All our wonderful Oshina Shetty is concerning the garbage and cleanliness. He is a brand ambassador where he works more than everyone on the root level. Even if I can, concerning our, if I need any suggestions, I call him and talk to him and like this, and then I go and talk in the assembly what I should talk regarding the garbage and sanitation. Iqbal is the Ayush director who has taken care not only of Ayurveda, of all the systems comes under him. Then Sister Jasmine, I not tell, she is always very cool. Any tension is there, she will take it very coolly. There is no time, always, no, I have never seen always any time. Whatever problem is there, Sister Jasmine is not tensioned at all. For that only God has given us Jasmine AC, always AC only, air conditioner, always cool. So you have got a wonderful, our principal and our administrator also, Roshan Krasta and Dr. Shiv Prasad. I think we have to congratulate Deepa Pais also for organizing all this program over here. Overall, we are all very lucky, and it's a God given opportunity for us also to participate in. I wish each and everyone a bright and colorful future. In the days to come, we'll go to the glory of heights. Not only you will keep the appearance or family's name high, and our country and our society's name also. So thanking you, wishing a bright and colorful future, thanking the organizers once again, and apologies for coming over late over here. Thank you.
Gratitude is the fairest blossom which springs from the soul. Respected dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, I deem it my honor to propose the vote of thanks on behalf of the organizers of Prerana 2020. Many are the plans in a man's heart, but it is the Lord's purpose for him that prevails. While thanking the Almighty for his countless blessings, I count on this blessing of the Lord Almighty for helping us to carry out Prerana 2020, an inter-school and inter-collegiate literary creativity fest and a health exhibition of this dimension. I take this opportunity to express my gratitude to our beloved director, the head of our institution, and the president of today's program, Reverend Father Richard Aloysius Cuello, for motivating us and supporting us in all our endeavors, especially in organizing Prerana. I thank him for his presence here and in absentia. Thank you, Father. My sincere thanks to Sri U.T. Kadar, member of Legislative Assembly, Mangalore Constituency, for consenting to be the chief guest of the day's program. Sir, I wholeheartedly thank you for accepting our invitation and making yourself available today for this program, and for your constant support to our institution and to the college, and of course for your inspiring message. Thank you, sir. My heartfelt gratitude to Dr. Mohammed Iqbal, District Ayush Officer, Dakshina Kannada, a guest of honor. We thank you, sir, for your presence here today and for your wholehearted support to the system of homeopathy. Thank you, sir. My sincere thanks to Sister Dr. Jeswina, Principal St. Agnes College, Bangalore, and my teacher and my mentor for your kind presence here. We are honored to have you amidst us here today, and we thank you, sister, for your thought-provoking message. We have amongst us here today Shri Sheena Shetty, District Sanitation Ambassador and the President of Jana Shikshana Trust, Dakshina Kannada, a very humble and dedicated person working for the society and the well-being of the common man, concentrating on sanitation. We thank you, sir, for your presence here and your keen interest you take for the upliftment and the development of homeopathic system of medicine. I'm extremely grateful to our dynamic and enthusiastic administrator, Reverend Father Roshan Krasta. It was his dream to have a medical exhibition of such a kind for the benefit of the budding students and the general public by way of promoting and popularizing homeopathy. Father always had a solution for every problem we approached him with. I once again thank you, Father, for all the motivation and cooperation you rendered for the success of Prayer in our 2020. My sincere gratitude to our Principal Dr. Shivaprasad K for giving us the right suggestions and timely guidance throughout the planning and the proceedings of Prayer in our. Thank you, sir. My sincere thanks to our Vice Principal Dr. ESJ Prabhukiran for his constant encouragement and support and timely assistance to us throughout the planning and coordination of this event. Thank you, sir. I also thank Reverend Father Peter Noronha, our founder director, and Reverend Father Felix Noronha, spiritual director, for all your prayers, blessings, and your constant support. Thank you, fathers. I would like to thank all the management committee and advisory committee members for accepting our invitation and for being with us today to make this program a meaningful one. I acknowledge and thank the presence of Dr. Varnekar, Principal Yenapoya Homeopathy Medical College, for his presence here. Thank you, sir. An event of this dimension cannot happen overnight. The wheels start rolling months in advance. Hence, this extra note of thanks goes to all the faculty and students of Padamala Homeopathy Medical College for the meticulous planning of this program. I am indebted to all the HODs of all the departments for your keen interest, meticulous planning and timely help in making Prayer in our 2020 a grand success. Thank you, teachers. I'm thankful to Dr. Raja Chandra, the co-convener of Prayer in our, for shouldering the responsibilities and looking into the minutest details of the health exhibition and the various competitions of Prayer in our. Thank you, Dr. Raja Chandra. I must mention and thank the in-charges of various committees who have helped us to organize this event. Dr. Jolly DiMello, the reception in-charge, and her team. Dr. Suraj for taking care of the logistics and all the arrangements. Dr. Vivek and Dr. Sebastian for designing the brochures, banners, certificates, bookmarks, pamphlets, and the mementos. Dr. Hafiz along with Dr. Ashik for taking care of the transport and the conveyance. Dr. Prenin, the finance in-charge. Dr. Jacinta Montero, stage in-charge. Dr. Ranjan Brito, the media coordinator. Dr. Anusha, Dr. Kurian and Dr. Vivek, the in-charge of the competitions. Dr. Skandan and Dr. Dheeraj, the quiz master, and all the judges of the various competitions. And to all the in-charges of the system-wise stalls which are put up beautifully outside, with their enthusiastic team comprising of the UGs, interns and the PGs. The models, charts and posters made by all you students is worth appreciating. It just wouldn't have been possible without you all. Thank you once again. A special note of thanks to the college council headed by the president, Mr. Nova, and his team for helping us to conduct this program. I am indebted to all the postgraduate students and UG students for being an integral part of this event. I am truly grateful to you all for your help, spending time beyond working hours continuously in making all the models, posters required for the exhibition and making the stalls outside very vibrant and colourful. Truly, you are the essence of the college. Thank you, dear students. I would like like to place on record the media personnel from the print and digital media for the presence here today and for the wide coverage they have given for the program, made it known to the public. Thank you. I would be failing in my duty if I fail to thank our sponsors and well-wishers who have contributed for the success of Prerana 2020. On behalf of the organizing committee, I thank you for your generous contribution and pray God's choicest blessings on you and your family as well. A word of appreciation to the principals and the head of the institution of all the colleges and students who have sent their students to participate in various competitions to be held today and tomorrow, and also for participation in the health exhibition in large numbers. We already have about 1,900 students who have registered for the exhibition and many more to come. My heartfelt thanks to the MCs Dr. Dheeraj Fernandez and Dr. Helena D'Souza for comparing this event, Ms. Nehala and team for the prayer song, the beautiful backdrop designed and implemented by our very own students headed by Dr. Sister Soumya, Jasna Jose and team, Dr. Anand Krishna, Dr. Ashams and their team for the promo, and all the student volunteers who have relentlessly toiled for the successful organization of this program. Thanks to Mrs. Nancy and all the administrative staff and the wardens of both the hostels, Sister Tressilla and Dr. Ashik, for their kind cooperation in organizing this event. My sincere thanks to Mrs. Rose Arrangers Vamanjur for the Shamiana and the logistic support, and Mr. Stanley, Anvita Photography, for making this event memorable through your photography and videography. A word of appreciation to the housekeeping in charge, Sister Christine and team, for all the physical arrangements, Mr. Bertie and team for the technical support, and all the non-teaching staff for all the cooperation rendered. Last but not the least, I thank each one of you all who has directly and indirectly helped for the smooth functioning of this program. I conclude by quoting Henry Ford's quote, which says, "If everyone is moving forward together, then success takes care of itself." Thank you once again and have a very pleasant day.